so that we need to set up a commission within our forest land once a day and support the commission to ensure that we get to the root of that problem and have recommendations that can be implemented for the amelioration of that problem and for its correction. And in the ways in which, the many ways in which we will go about having a manifesto that is attractive, we must make sure that our candidates are involved in the ideas which we are generating. I'm getting reports that quite often candidates are asked in the houses, what does the Labour Party propose to do about X problem or Y problem? And many of them are saying that they have not seen the manifesto yet and that they do not know. It is not a satisfactory answer. The Labour Party has a heavy responsibility to so equip our candidates that though they do not give away at this stage or claims, because there are many of them who would like to run with them and claim them as their own, that in general terms they have an intelligent response to the questions that people may be asking. That is very important. And so our candidates need to be equipped with general, at this stage, even not specific answers to the questions that intelligent voters are concerned about and will ask them in the houses and on the doorsteps. One or two people have told me that the candidates have said that they're ready to hear what Mr. Arthur says about these issues. We have to be very careful. In the run-up to the last election, I was of the view that the Barbados Labour Party has become a one-man party. This could be an election like 1991, where the centres of every constituency march a man. And to that extent, you have to prepare for a hard battle in every constituency and not assume that you will be the beneficiary of a landslide. You have to get behind the candidates, and if they are not working hard enough, tell them that. And don't be afraid to tell them that. And they have to work sensibly in more ways than one. This constituency here that stands is, it is a large constituency. The old constituencies is a large constituency. These areas have attracted large amounts of middle class settlement. You cannot therefore work in any one area for 2 months. You can spend 3-4 days as you try to tackle and crack the nut in a particular big area, assuming you're doing 5 days of canvassing at this time, and everybody should be doing a minimum of 4. But you also have to spend 2 days going back to areas that you never covered before, and driving around, calling on people, particularly going to public places where people congregate, so that everybody is saying, I'm seeing the girl Sandra, I'm seeing the girl Sandra. You must demonstrate to the people that you have fire in your belly, yes, and that you are ready and anxious to go. Yes. If they think you are lazy and people say, oh, no, that fella and the guy sees you last 4 months, that does not help your image. Work hard and make 1,000 applications. The Labour Party must present itself as a united force. But if you really go and knock on a house and then a perplexed lady, because she's never seen you before, look out. You say that my name is John Brown and I am the Barbados Labour Party candidate and I'm here to persuade you to vote for the Barbados Labour Party in the next election. And she said, when is that? And you said, well, I don't know, but sometime in the next year. And she said, well, many times come against me.
At that point,
you have made no impact whatsoever. You have made no impact whatsoever. And so you have to give great thought to how you reach people at their level. She might not be a woman particularly interested in politics, even though she exercises her civic responsibility. She might be overblown by personal family problems or other problems, and you have made no impact whatsoever. But if you go in, particularly if you are supported by informed people working with you or a person, they're able to tell you the lady who is Miss Gill. She got 3 votes in the house, her son and her cousin live here. The rest of the family overseas. And so the lady or the gentleman who is working with you to say, Miss Gill, it's me so and so. She said, oh, what are you doing here? She knows her. The person is known. She's already beat the candidate. And she said, oh, come in. But on his way in, he notices that the house has a different color from the other houses in the street. There's a flower garden. And as soon as he goes in, he sees 2 young men, handsome pictures on the wall. And so, he's not moving straight to politics. Let me see you, Terry, let me see you. He's not moving straight to politics. But he's saying, Mom, tell me something about these handsome young boys. These photographs on the wall. She immediately lets up. There are her grandchildren. Only a year ago, you went learning with a mate. She went to England and see them with her daughter. And she's talking about that. And you have any children yourself? You're making contact at the human level. You ain't really the politics yet. She's asking you whether you have any children of your own, and how old they are, and how they're doing, and so on. And then you notice the flower garden, and you will come in, and you comment in a very complimentary way on the flowers. You said, boy, you don't know how much joy I get from being in the flower garden, and so on. All of that now has allowed you to make the contact at the human level. And she herself then may say, tell me how I could help you. And then you introduce the politics and your plan. But if you go in the abrupt way, and I'm sure that some candidates are standing in the room and shouting at people and telling them who they are and what the past is about, it can't work that way. You must maximize your presence in the houses. You must make sure you make contact at the human level and not with the other canvassing. And so you have to master the psychology of canvassing and understand that you can't stop the driver telling them, and these people might not be politically alert even though the vote. My name is John Ball, and I'm here on behalf of the Labour Party, and ask you for the support on the next occasion. It cannot be abrupt like that. So that by the time you leave the house, if you are flexible in the way you do it, there is much laughter, and the lady says, I hope I see you again before the election. You must pass and give me a visit. All of that she will hear if you strike the right notes and if you go about it in the right way. So that is a lot more to canvassing than just knocking on the door. And I hope that all the candidates and those who work with them, the foot soldiers, understand that.